beautiful Puget Sound just to our west. You get a look inside CenturyLink Field here in Seattle. This crowd, as we've come to expect in recent years, as loud as any in the NFL, and they get even louder when their Seahawks are introduced. We're ready for football as the Seahawks get set to do battle. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. With Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers.
Green 80!
Seven on that first down pass play. Second and three.
Right, Brady.
Right. From the shotgun, Wilson. To the right side, he's got more complete. His first catch, good for eight and a first down.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had to read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a nice game.
This is
going to
be caught.
Situation for him, as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. That little arc on it, he's got to find a way to get his head around and make the play on the football.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now. First down. Now a play fake here on first down. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. These two teams met in week one a year ago, and that went to the Packers in a slugfest 17-9. Now, remember, they also met in the NFC title game of the 2014 season. It was the Seahawks who prevailed their 28-22 on a Jermaine Kearse touchdown catch in overtime. Here's second and 10 now from the 29.
He's done, Delaney!
Second and 10, it's Wilson again. Going back to Moore, this time he's got him complete. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
I know from past experience, before you actually play a game, you visualize what's going to happen. And I don't know anyone who doesn't visualize themselves being in the center of what's going on. That's three catches for him here in the early going. He's got to like the way this is starting.
Absolutely. Three catches on any drive is good. Opening drive, that's a chance. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
Three down.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. And Janikowski bends it through, and the Seahawks grab a 3-0 lead. So the first points of the night, knowing their home team is able to take the opening kickoff and at least get 3 points out.
Yeah, that helps the crowd, right? Helps people feel good about why they're there watching this game. They move the ball well on their opening drive.
Now after the made field goal, here's Sebastian Janikowski to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And a good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their own 24.
58.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. And now incomplete. What a took a shot there on the first play, trying to start it out with a bang. But second down. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
They really turned it loose, didn't they? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he is made quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a third and 11 situation. A field goal, you'd hate to go three and out. They avoid that.
They do, and it's also walking that fine line mentally too as a coach, isn't it? Because you want to emphasize to your team exactly what you said. All right, we gave the field goal. Let's get back to these easy ones. But we don't. You're going to throw this into the world. Nice of the world to pick up the first down there. Help them relax a little bit.
And a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want. Get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35.
And it is 319. And
second down is Jones. And Knight back to the line of scrimmage this time as they're on him quickly once more. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play. And that'll force upon him a third and 14. As it moves the offense backwards. On fourth down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. Back deep, the dangerous Tyler Lockett. At the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there. Nowhere. He'll lose yardage back at the 17. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that'll make this a second and 13.
Assignments, it doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Check three, check three. Move 15!
Out of the gun, here's Wilson. And that's Dixon left side. And down he'll go at the 25. Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number 2. But likely not for long as they're in punt formation to kick it away. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And the crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach
can go in there
and not try to force something that can put your teammates in jeopardy.
Throwing to stop the drive, but that one incomplete. Best CD, a quick look back at week four of the NFL. Not good for rookie QBs. They went 0-4. Yet Rosen and Mayfield making their first starts. Both close losses.
Yeah, and Sam Darnold took on Jacksonville, one of the better defenses in the league. That's a tough go, and obviously lost that game. And then how about Josh Allen in Buffalo going to Green Bay?
Green Bay team!
Uniforms. He almost didn't have a chance, and now that was really difficult. But you mentioned Rosen and Mayfield. Close losses. Acquitted themselves pretty well overall. Although Mayfield did turn it over four times in the game. But I like what we're seeing out of him. The one winner, though, is Lamar Jackson.
But
it doesn't go on his record. He wasn't the starting quarterback. Used a little bit in their game, and they win over Pittsburgh. Sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. That's as good as it gets. So through a partnership with our friends at Nike, you're going to see custom one-of-a-kind gold 99 club kicks and gloves reserved for guys like Antonio Brown, Gronk, and Luke Kuechly.
And you and I were fortunate enough to get an early sneak peek at them. And I'll tell you, for my money, really cool thing that they're doing. Sharp, sharp look. And how cool will it be for those guys to be part of that exclusive club and have something that no one else in the league has? That signifies them as 99s. That's pretty cool.
And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. Rodgers to Cobb, good for a Green Bay first.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion.
Yo, hey, let's go.
Keeps
come on.
The sticks moving.
Internet! 319! 319! 319!
From midfield, here's Rodgers. Nice goal. Oh. There he goes. The best name in the NFL. Kevius Winger. And it'll be a second and long. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust an account for that?
But what you hope is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you. You change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection.
319.
The biggest one is maybe bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability and a sack resulted.
False start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there
to admit I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right? Whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs.
Right. Green 80.
Yeah, just something to build on. That's what they're looking for here. And he'll get only a couple after the 22.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
From the 22, here's second and eight.
Four down, four down. Right, 3-15.
Now it's Carson, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Looks like the Packers have added an extra DB on third down.
Right, Mulaney.
From the gun, it's Wilson. Wilson is going to be incomplete.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
Now here's Michael Dixon as he'll punt it away for the second time. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Fielded just inside the 20. A big boot that time. 57 yards the official distance. And that will come the offense as they take over. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. They've had it twice. They punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So the furious of the teams on the sidelines, what do we need to do to pick up the first down and change the momentum?
Looking middle, and it's incomplete. Now there's a pass on first down. It's knocked away.
Defensively, is that they're showing them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They come after them, they sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10.
And 18.
Rodgers again here on second and 10. He's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. Now Rodgers. It's incomplete. The linebacker Bobby Wagner able to get back in coverage and knock it free.
And that's why he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Hey, 319.
Now Rodgers, catch it again. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 to 44. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
The Packers on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Exactly 10. And by the hands of the football, they've got a first down. For the sideline, what a catch.
Let's go, come on.
Get a lot out of it. But he is able to keep the feet in bounds. 4 yards on the pickup, and it'll be 2nd down. Rodgers to throw once more. And his throw is incomplete. Knocking it away there defensively, Justin Coleman. On 3rd down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This will be 3rd and 6.
Green 18!
Again, that throw with Rodgers. He's got the hookup to Moore. That will be taken down at the 44-yard line. That's got the throw in 3 that time, and that'll bring up 4th down.
I know where we're headed on this. Terrific catch. Gets his feet down. Sets up a 4th down and short situation. I bet we're wondering, why didn't he get to the 1st down marker running his route? Am I correct?
You got to know where the marker is, right?
Got to figure it out. I know every receiver's taught that.
And a fake here. Direct snap to the upfield. And again, hands off. They get the first. And now before this 1st down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10.
Green 18! Rodgers
now on 1st down. Underneath to Jones. An agile move and a nice game. Then dropped at the 25-yard line. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Get 7 on that 1st down pass play. 2nd and 3.
319.
From the goal. Rodgers. Incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. So on 3rd down, a field goal unit will come out as they'll try to get 3 before half. From the left hash, it's a 42-yard attempt. And Crosby puts it through, and that will knock things up here late in the 1st half. Well, maybe a nice psychological boost there just to get back to even with that field goal as we head towards half.
Coaching 101 always says at halftime, play it like it's 0-0 on the scoreboard. In this case, it's level, right? Same score each side. Just start over. Now you've got the 2nd half to play.
So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. This will be taken in at the 1. So we've reached halftime in a low-scoring affair. Just a pair of field goals. 3-3 is our score. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Rodgers will bring the pack up with a 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Let's go. Come on.
After the sack on a second and 12.
Green 19.
Now a play fake. Rodgers. Caught left side by Cole. Now he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. A nice gain of 21 yards.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there. Turns into something big.
The stop for no gain brings up second and 10 from the 20. Such a good route runner, shows it there on third down, very proficient and a good pass.
And you know, over the years in the NFL, the better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's gonna have in you to go to you in a time, because he can trust you in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up the first down.
And he only manages a couple here down to about the 38-yard line. They struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
It's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar. You
circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. You just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
Green 19!
Now whistles here, flag down. I think one of the Packer linemen was moving. False start backs him up five, first and 15.
Green 19, look at the 8.
Talked about at halftime, whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
Took till the second half, but finally a red zone opportunity. They have a first and 10 at the 13-yard line. Well, Ryan Jones. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
319!
It's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that
play.
So the false start will back them up five. And maybe they were coming with a blitz that time, and it caused a jump.
I think if we saw it, you know that they saw it. Might have been a little discussion down there. Bad guys coming. Pick them up. Pick them up. And someone jumped.
And a manageable third down becomes a lot less manageable. Third and seven after the false start.
And on it. The 58. Three right there.
Now it's Rodgers. And almost intercepted. Would have been a huge pick in the end zone, but as it stands, that brings up four.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
And Crosby puts it through, and they will take the lead here in this battle of field goals at 6-3. So they get three, certainly hoping for six after a 13-play drive.
So you console yourself on defense by saying you did your job, right? If they go 13 plays, you only give up a field goal. You did a nice job there. But here's the other part. 13 plays, you don't force any mistakes. You don't take the ball away. Maybe that's the way they should look at it.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. This is taken at the three. And they take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Now we'll see what this Seahawks offense has in store with their first possession of the second half. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even get close on the board. The Cowboys take a deep breath, relax, try to figure out what is working, and talk more of that.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, you have to punt on your first drive, and on the first play, the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
Back now in Seattle, Washington. A very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter.
Right, lady.
On second down, Wilson. And Dixon over the middle. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks.
As so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work. And that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down. Jankowski on for the PAT. Jankowski adds the extra point. And that will make this a four-point game.
out to kick is Janikowski. This is fielded a couple yards deep. Stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. They also have to remember they did put points on the board.
Green 18!
You take points when you can get it.
It's caught on the right side by Jones. And we get to the 29-yard line drop down there. To gain a 5 on the play, and it'll make it second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They tackle them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Just short of the 45 at the 44. They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people think it's a fancy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
319! 319, get on it! Get on it!
First and 10, here's Rodgers. Drops it to Jones in the flat. A swift move and then tackled just on the other side of midfield. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll bring up second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
319! 319!
Now whistles here, flag down. I think one of the Packer linemen was moving. Now after the false start, here's second and 7.
You're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
319!
Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best ones for the top running back. Those are the ones you focus on and want to take away. And they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
319!
Now Rodgers, down on this one. And he finds his tight end, Graham. Give him credit, they knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there. Rodgers will bring him up to the line, first and 10. And he's hit on all 5 of his pass attempts on this drive so far.
319! 319!
Shotgun to Rodgers. That's to pick up that pitch and catch.
Move the Jason on it!
Back to throw. The man outside is sent down. And finally, as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Someone moved, flag is out, that's going to be 5 yards.
And that'll drive coaches crazy. You work all week on dealing with loud crowds, on dealing with motion, and then you have a guy jump.
That false start knocks them back behind the 10 now as they'll try again, first and goal.
319!
He's back to throw. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
319!
Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal.
319!
You're saying, hey, yeah, you're in the red zone. We're thinking we're giving up three. We're just going to give up six. In this case, they end up not giving up the touchdown. They're going to feel
great about what they got. Now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. As the clock will stop with 55 seconds remaining in the football game. And out now come the Seahawks. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Alert! Alert! Right!
Right back to him on first down. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Now the Packers going to take another timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. This, in all probability, another run here on second and 8. And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. The Seahawks in victory formation as they go ahead and take the knee. Now here's Michael Benson as he's on to punt for Seattle. That's going to go on the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And control of the football, switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaunt. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. It's a win for the Seahawks here as we say so long from Seattle.